paper recently published in
Bioarchive.
So the title is The Laminin Keratin Link Shields the Nucleus from the Mechanical Deformation and Signaling. Yeah. Published by Perorosha Group in Spain. So please let's read the abstract together. The mechanical property of the ECM dictate tissue behavior. Well known. In epithelial tissue, laminin is both an abundant ECM component and a key supporting element. Here, we show that laminin hinder the mechanical responsive of breast epithelial cell by shielding the nucleus from mechanical deformation. Coating substrate with laminin 111, major component of the lamin, unlike fibronectin or collagen 1, impairs cell response to the substrate rigidity and YAP nucleolocalization. Blocking the laminin-specific integrin 4 increased nuclear YAP ratio in a rigidity-dependent manner without affecting the cell force or focal adhesion. By combining mechanical perturbation and mathematical modeling, we show that beta 4 integrin establishes a mechanical linkage between the substrate and the keratin cytoskeleton, which stiffens the network and shields the nucleus from the ectomyosin-mediated mechanical deformation. In turn, this affects nuclear YAP mechanical responses and chromatin methylation. Our results demonstrate a mechanism by which tissue can regulate their sensitivity to mechanical signals. So when you look at this basal laminar structure, so as you know, top one is epithelial cell, and below is fibroblast tissue. So sorry, what's going on? So when you look at the skin, the top layer is consists of epithelial cell, and the below is fibroblast layer. Those two layers is divided by this basal lamina. So basal lamina, in basal lamina, the laminin is one of the most abundant ECM. So these people, they look at the cell behavior on the laminin-coated polyacrylamide gel. And then they confirm the cell behavior is somewhat different from the fibronectin coating one. So the basal, why they look at this laminin? Because in terms of the cancer cell starts from the epithelial cell. And then they have to penetrate this basal lamina and then go to the fibroblast abundant layer. So for EMT, epithelial mesenchymal transition, for EMT, basal lamina penetration is very important. So in this paper, they mentioned that laminin abundant structure, the cell behave is not that much stiffness dependent sensitivity. But when they meet the fibronectin or collagen 1, which are abundant, more abundant in fibroblast layer, they start to show high sensitivity to the stiffness. The basal story is like that. So let's see one by one the figure. So first, they culture the epithelial cell, breast cancer cell line, and then they coated three different components, laminin, collagen 1, and fibronectin. In our iTrain, most of the time we use fibronectin. So when you look at the collagen 1 and fibronectin, they show stiffness-dependent traction force behave. But somehow, when same cell are cultured on laminin-coated one, they show decrease of traction force. So they found, oh, it's very interesting. And then, this is their image. From the B, they obtain the A value. So when you look at the red one, is more high traction force, below is low traction force. Laminin has lower than other collagen and fibronectin depending on the stiffness. And then they quantify the focal adhesion, and then actin anisotropy means how they align, and then YAP, nuclear translocation ratio. So let's see one by one. In case of focal adhesion length, this gray one is laminin. Laminin, especially in high stiffness, they show decrease of length compared to others. Here, in case of high stiffness, especially compared to collagen 1 and fibronectin, this focal adhesion length is a little bit shorter than others. We can confirm it. And 11 and 30 kilopascal. And in terms of actin anisotropy, how actin is aligned, in high kilopascal, especially, this gray is generally lower than others. So when you look at this, you can see more actin filament here and here compared to others, laminin. So also actin anisotropy is lower than others when the cell, epithelial cell, are cultured on the laminin coated one. The next, YAB is your most key co-transcription factor to sense the stiffness. So they check how the YAB is nucleolocalized. So over the rigidity, the gray one, laminin coated cell, they show a little bit increasing, but not that much. The other, collagen and fibronectin, they show very stiff slope, but the gray is lower slope. So when you look at the image, the others, they show more prominent YAP nuclear telomere localization. But in case of laminin, it seems to nuclear localize, but the intensity is not that much. So they found out that somehow this laminin coating impairs, damage the cell mechanosensing in response to substrate rigidity. And let's go next. And then, as you know, the laminin, fibronectin, when the cell can attach on the fibronectin coated one, they use special integrin set, alpha-3, beta-5, alpha-5, beta-1, something like. So in case of integrin, in case of laminin, also they have special integrin set, which is integrin beta 4 and alpha 6 and beta 1 alpha 3. So they want to check, this is their functional inhibitor. So integrin beta 4 means they inhibit the integrin beta 4, not to recognize the laminin structure on the substrate. So control means, this is control, the round gray. But when you look at the integrin beta 4, somehow in high stiffness, it starts to show increase of focal adhesion length, which means even though cells are culturing on the laminin substrate, but they feel that they cannot sense the laminin because we block the integrin 4. So they sense like they are cultured on the other substrate. But especially beta 4 and alpha 6, they little bit increase, but others, otherwise they are decreasing. So this is a very interesting phenomenon. So when you look at this this image, this is a control on laminin, right? But when you look at the beta 4 and alpha 6, low and high stiffness, a little bit, maybe in high stiffness, not that much, but in low stiffness, especially they show very prominent focal adhesion length. Then other integrin blocking. Actually, this image is not exactly matched to this, but they describe like that. And then they check the YAP nuclear translocalization. Interestingly, the beta 4 and alpha 6, green is beta 4, yellow is alpha 6, they show increase of YAP nuclear localization on laminin substrate compared to just without control group, which means the cell, when they attach on the laminin by this alpha 4 and alpha 6 beta 4 integrin set, they sense laminin, and then YAM nuclear localization is diminished than others. But when we block it, they go up. They feel like they are culturing on the other substrate, the laminin. So this is their conformation. Control is like this. But when we block the beta 4 and alpha 6, the hyaline nuclear torus localize than others integrin. And then they want to check some cell traction force. Cell traction force, but somehow no significant difference. So, which means the cell, they generate same force. But how they recognize the substrate component is important for regulating their mechanosensing behavior. Cell force doesn't change, but depending on the integrin set to sense the component of the ECM, they control the YAP nucleotide localization, which means mechanosensing behavior. And then they check POSPO MLC is a marker of the cell traction force. When they are increasing, they generate more force, but forces doesn't change by the Western blot and then cell traction force study. So integrin alpha 6 beta 4 alter nuclear mechanosensing on laminin. The next, they want to know how, okay, integrin beta alpha 6 beta 4, they are linking to change the mechanosensing behavior. And then how they change, how mechanosensing axis is controlled. So they focus on the plectin and keratin. So plectin is one of the linker between integrin and then intermediate filament, which is keratin. So they check the composition and then distribution of the plectin and keratin. Here, especially in terms of keratin, control means the epithelial breast cancer cell on laminin substrate. Keratin A, they form like that, homogeneously formed. But when we block the beta 4, the keratin formation somehow change. So this is coefficient variation means how they change. So beta 4 is blocking inside of the cell, highly keratinate, but periphery area less. That is why they show more variation. And then, so especially peripheral intensity is dramatically decreasing in the beta 4 function antibody treated one. And then, also they observe, so intermediate filament keratin is changed depending on the integrin set. And then they want to check. They make two things. One is normal integrin set plectin keratin. The other one is they are mutated of the plectin structure. So the integrin set, they cannot bind to the keratin. So they block the mechanosensing behave in this mutant cell. So this is a control cell. As we always observe, they show some increase, but the slope is like this. But when we inhibit this plectin keratin mechanosensing mechanotransduction axis, they show high, which means somehow this mechano axis is important to downregulate the nuclear translocalization. And then this is their image for this quantification. So compared to a normal cell, when we mutate this mechano axis, all of them, they show more high nuclear translocalization. And then even focal adhesion is enhanced. Focal adhesion, their length is enhanced. So mechanical role of integrin beta 4 is mediated by its connection to plectin and keratins. So initially they try to observe the actin is changed or not, but in the supplementary data they show that actin doesn't change in terms of this beta 4 functional study. So they want to know which one is mediated this phenomenon. So that is why at the second option they focus on the intermediate filament keratin. And then using the computer modeling, they try to understand how actin and keratin, they are co-regulate each other. So they focus on actin substrate friction. Friction means the force between the actin and focal adhesion. How they strongly adhere to the substrate. And then keratin substrate friction, which is mediated by the alpha 5 beta 6 in our case, right? So actin is also depolymerized. Keratin also depolymerized. While they are dynamically changed, actin flow and keratin flow. So they put some input and then they got the result. So this is their computer modeling. This is about B and C. So one is peripheral area, and then zero means central area. The keratinine density, they expect that normal is like that, but when they are mutated, this keratin substrate friction, they go down. And then actin doesn't change. So important thing is that actually actin, they try to compress the cell and nucleus. But in meanwhile, intermediate filament, they opposite. They support. They try to support the actin and then preserve the nucleus shape. So these two is, they show different direction of the force. And then this is their modeling. So they confirm by their hands. So in this mutated cell, as we expect before from the modeling, the coefficient variation, which means how center and peripheral they are changed, they are dramatically changed. Peripheral is more. And then when you look at this image, so center and peripheral, they almost similar to this expectation, the keratin intensity here. And then, but actin intensity doesn't change that much. Also, they check the actin velocity, how they fast the actin flow, and then keratin flow. So this is their expectation from the modeling. They expect like that. And then this is their result of the cell. Similarly, actin doesn't change that much, but when we mutate the integrin, plectin, and keratin structure, they change a lot of the keratin velocity. And then keratin 18 and keratin velocity here. So and this is their image for this quantification. Yellow one means more speed they change. So more speed in center, but the mutated one, the flow is changed. And then they want to know this keratin also can sense the external force, and then they respond to the external force. So they are using optical tweezer. So they coat this silica bead using laminin, and then attach on the top of the cell, and then they move by the tweezer using this frequency. And then they observe normal cell depending on the oscillatory cycle, which means depending on how they induce external force, they change the cell stiffness, change, increasing, respond to the external force. But in mutated cell, they didn't change that much. But this is laminin binding on the bead, but fibronectin binding, even though we mutate the keratin integrin set, they show the similar pattern, which means this mutation keratin mutation is only react to the laminin substrate, not the fibronectin substrate. So, and then this is their Young's modulus of the cytoplasm and on the top of the nucleus. So this normal cell, compared to normal cell, mutated cell, they show decreasing of stiffness. cause, as you can expect, intermittent filament and the integrin set, they are debinding, break, so there is no help for support the nucleus. So when they push the general stiffness of the cell, they are decreasing. And then here they discuss like that. This is their, how can I say, original epithelial cell. When they in the epithelial layer, the external force dependent behavior, like that. But when the cell penetrate to the basal lamina and then approach to the fibroblast layer, fibro tissue, after EMT phenomenon, they are more stiffness external force dependently react. And then now they go deep to the nucleus shape. So how nucleus shape is changed? Sphericity is one is more round, zero means more flattened. So because of the lack of the intermittent filament support for preserved nucleus, they show more flattened. So when you look at the 3D images, most of them are round shape compared to this flattened nucleus. Nuclear ellipticity is another terminology like nuclear sphericity. So how they are flattened? This is how one is how they are flattened. Sphericity is one is circle, but in ellipticity one is flattened. They are more flattened like that compared to normal cell. And then they stretch the epithelial cell and then check how they respond. So before stretch, during the stretch, the cell generally behave change like that. But in case of cell strain, the general morphology change similarly, 30% change. But nucleus strain, more dramatically change in the mutated one. Cause intermittent filament and integrin, they are breaking. There is no support for preserved nucleus. So they are more, nucleus is more changeable by the external force. And then, yeah, this is their image of the cell and nucleus. You can see more gap between relax and stretch compared to normal cell when they mutate them. And then this cache is a nesprin nucleus membrane component, which is called link complex. So DN cache one means they damage the actin and nucleus membrane binding, physical binding. So when they debind the mechanosensing axis to the nuclear membrane using DN cache transfection, both of them are decreasing, which means from the integrin set here, when you go up, even though from the starting point, actin substrate, keratin substrate, they are different, but finally, when they transmit the force to nucleus, they are using same link complex. So they didn't follow another new mechanosensing component. They follow the traditional link complex, nucleus membrane binding, but starting point is different. So they observe from this integrin alpha-6 beta-4, plectin and keratin structure, when they are mutated, nuclear shape is changed. And then, when as you expect, nuclear shape is changed under stretch or external force, epigenetic could change, right? So now they go to the epigenetic change. So this is Yeah, for before that, they want to know this phenomenon is depending on the traditional actomyosin contractility mechanotransduction axis. So they are treating blebbistatin actomyosin contraction inhibitor CK-6666, which is ARP23 inhibitor, which decreased branching of the actin. And then they treat both of them. So interestingly, actually, I saw this interesting finding here, and then they referred one paper. When they treat the blebbistatin, somehow YAB is enhanced. This is very new for me. So when I look at the other paper, most of them, when the blebbistatin treated, the YAB is decreasing. But here they mention increasing. But they refer one paper in JCB. Also, they show the this M-shaped cell line. They look increasing when the blebbistatin treated. And then CK-666 treated, they are look decreasing. Both of them, they are decreasing. And then this mutated one, also similarly, when they block this CK-666, they are decreasing. And then both of them, they are decreasing. So they want to say, even though the keratin is mutated, also YAP, they can be regulated by the actin axis. So actin and intermediate filament, they also link together. They are not alone. They always link together using some component. So they generalized their observation, YAP, nuclear translocation, and then sphericity. Sphericity of the nucleus, decreasing means more flattened. More flattened means the nucleus feel the sense of the force, and then when nucleus sense the force, the nuclear YAP more translocalized, regardless of this inhibitor study. And then this is their sphericity decreasing means more flattened. Under inhibitor, both of them flattened. And then they briefly look at this H3K27 methylation 3, which is a repressor of the gene. So this is their normal status. Repressor is less. But when they mutated the keratin mechanotransduction, repression is enhanced. Repression is enhanced cause the cell more nucleus more flattened, and then YAP is more nuclear localized. So under this context, this repressor is more enhanced. So they mentioned that this is some kind of, how can I say, self-defense mechanism. So in the cell paper published in other group, they utilize a stretch, maybe 15% stretch, maybe 2 days. Somehow epithelial cell, they try to preserve their nucleus, so some epigenetic change occur. So they refer their paper. So anyhow, they want to say that this one of the key epigenetic change, this repressor in epithelial cell, they change depending on the this keratin mechanotransduction axis. And then G and H is their in vivo finding. They stain the basal lamina component, laminin alpha 1, and then they look at the high laminin positive area, low laminin alpha 1 positive area. In low laminin positive area, they observe less nuclear localization. Cause, but this laminin abundant area, more YAP. Sorry. This intensity is look increasing in here, but when you look at the nuclear localization, YAB is more less nuclear localization in laminin abundant area. But here they look go inside. So they show that laminin expression in vivo tissue and then YAB nuclear translocalization, they show like this tendency. More laminin. Yes, less YAP, less laminin, more YAP. So they want to say that in normal epithelial cell, they preserve their less YAP nucleotide localization using the laminin binding. But somehow they penetrate the basal lamina and then approach to the fibroblast layer by the EMT, which is cancer, and then they start to show more YAP nucleolocalization and then more sensitive to the external force. They mention like that. And then in the discussion, they say that they also, depending on the laminin intensity, so malignant cancer cell, they show less laminin secretion than normal cancer cell or non-malignant cancer cell. They also refer this paper using this finding. Okay, and then let's go to the supplementary data. So supplement data, yeah, this is we observe low and high stiffness. In case of laminin, less nucleolocalized, but collagen fibronectin, they are more localized. Focal adhesion length, decreasing in laminin than others. And then, as you know, epithelial cell, here we culture the epithelial cell single, not monolayer. But as you know, epithelial cell always behave as a monolayer. So they look at the center and edge. As you know, center always, they show cell-cell inhibition. So YAP never internalized in the nucleus. But in case of edge, this normal, YAP is, they are more migrating, so YAP is more translocalized. But when they block the integrin beta 4, the laminin binding integrin, they show more YAP nucleolocalization. They also cultured this one in the laminin coated PAA. So they found that not only single, but also the other physiological cell interaction behave under condition, this integrin beta 4 functional is working. So beta 4 is blocking more YAP, number of YAP is more increasing, but center doesn't change because cell inhibition. And then they observed the beta 4 expression by the cell depending on the stiffness. They show on the laminin coated one, in the laminin, their stiffness dependent increasing of the beta 4. But in case of collagen 1 coated PAA, they didn't change. So this beta 4 is laminin dependently the cell expressed. And then this is another inhibitor study. So also this paxilin, in case of functional, when we inhibit this beta 4 function, the focal adhesion doesn't change. And then keratin, the level doesn't change, but the keratin, how can I say, their distribution is changed under normal cell and then mutated cell. So cause this plectin, integrin beta 4, they confirm they are really not linked together. But in normal cell, they are linking, which means this is normal mechanical transduction, but we successfully break it by the plectin integrin beta 4 dissociation. And then this is their keratin 8 and beta 4. And then traction force, they show that in case of mutation, they are increasing, confirm. And then, in the main figure, we already showed that using this Nesprin 3 siRNA or cache, the whether they start from different manner, but finally, they should using Nesprin 3 or nuclear link complex for transmitting the force to the nucleus. And then others is about their modeling. So modeling, and then Laminase level doesn't change that much. Laminase is important for nuclear mechanical sensing. Yeah. This is the older paper.